Hello, folks. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me today. During the last Northern Light event, I kind of missed out. I didn't know about it, so I'm giving everyone a heads up about the one that's coming probably Friday and Saturday. So you might want to go out then and take a look to see if you can see any Northern Lights. A coronal hole, they say about 20 times the size of Earth, has been spotted. This is the second one. I believe this is actually probably about three times of the sun's surface. You can actually see this is the bigger one. Coronal hole one. We got coronal hole two, four, five, and three. And then down here, let me bring it down. It's not showing. Here we go. It says area percentage, 3.0% for corona hole one. Two is 0.8%. 3, 0.4. 4 is 0.1%. And 5 would be 0.1%. So corona hole one would be 3% of the sun's surface towards Earth. This image here is the coronal hole, the several coronal holes, and the areas of solar flares. They are expecting the winds to hit our planet Friday or Saturday and create auroras. Normally we have solar flares, an image of recent solar flares that impact our Earth and create the Northern Lights. You can see we got several C flares. There's one X flare. X1.2, that was on March 29th, an M1, and an M5 it shows here. This follows the recent discovery of a coronal hole on the sun, 30 times the size of the Earth. As this coronal hole, which many reported seeing the Northern Lights, begins rotating away from us, a new giant coronal hole, about 20 times the size of the Earth, came into view. Here we have an image of the KP index. Normally the coronal holes are at the north and south pole of the sun. But as the sun gears up to a peak activity, which happens about every 11 years, these holes are more commonly appear near the equator of the sun. Here's an aurora forecast, and this one is for today. Solar winds can be very fast, anywhere from 800,000 kilometers per second to about 1.8 million miles per hour. They say they expect the winds from the coronal hole to impact the Earth Friday night and into Saturday morning this week. Normally, the sun, the churning plasma, is very hot, and in these areas where they call the coronal holes, the plasma is much cooler, and the plasma shoots straight up instead of being affected by the magnetic field and throwing out coronal mass ejections and looping out. So it's an area where the energy is being projected straight out. Here is the projection for the solar winds. And you can see at the top, we got the date, and it starts out on the 28th, and then through the 31st, it goes through. And you can see this red mass of the solar winds. Looks like we might be just on the edges of it. Yeah, so I'm definitely going to go out tonight and take a look, see if I can see. In my area, normally they show up as green hues. There, see it, how it goes across there? So the image here on the left is the coronal hole impacting the Earth and what they're predicting. And I'll show you that. Now this is for the North Pole area. And I'll show you the one for the South Pole. Let me bring this over and we'll play this one for you. And at the top would be the time and date. Okay. There we go. Yeah, it doesn't look like it'll impact Australia, but you just don't know. This is just a forecast, what they're expecting. And it goes all the way through, let's see, maybe just today. I don't know if it has tomorrow. Nope, it does not have tomorrow. All right, let's bring this back over. And you can see the time and the date there at the top. So we got the 29th, which was yesterday, and then today as it grows. And, yeah, it comes really close to the Canadian border. Now, this is a chart for helium, which comes from the sun, and the plasma. And you can see here, this might be what's coming in or going to be coming in relatively soon, or it just happened. Yeah, it doesn't say which chart is for helium or which chart is for protons. I'll give you a link to all these different images I'm showing you. Now, this is the protons, and this is for today, and the time, which I imagine would be universal time. Looks like it's all by Greenwich time. Okay, and then what else do we got down here? Okay. And it goes back, yeah. They also have a page, some might be interested in it, I don't know, for X flares that there's been in the past. You can see January 20th, 2005, there was an X71. October 28th, 2003, an X172. November of 2001, an X1. November of 2000, an X7.4, and then July 2020, an X5.7. Yeah, it may cause adverse weather. Well, tonight, where I'm at, we're on alert for severe weather. Yeah, freezing rain and more snow. And it may cause earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. We'll just have to wait and see. Yeah, but something to be aware of. Anyways, yeah, get out there tonight and maybe early morning before the sun comes up, see if you can see anything. And maybe tomorrow night, or Saturday night, I should say, Friday and Saturday night. But I would give myself a 3-day window to get out there and see. Only once have I ever seen the curtain of colors here in South Dakota of the northern lights, where it was red and yellow and greens and blues. Oh gosh, that was probably 25 years ago. But normally when they have them here and we can see them, it's just a greenish light green color. But you never know. Anyways, thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please make sure you're still subscribed. At the end of the month, the AI for YouTube, for some reason, mistakenly, supposedly, unsubscribes people. And as always, please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.